Hey, yeah, you know what I forgot to do? Get with you. I need some guys in with the damn photo. Get with me. And I will tell them what it is so I can give them. I'm going to be outside this door. But actually, just Tim, stand right there beside this door, please.
Chief, you're in. You're in the floor.
shit.
Yeah, we were saying the fucking belly to lose, we were fucking.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'll send the kind of bushes.
It
was good. You just gotta get in close. Get loud.
Oh,
you gotta get loud. When you couldn't hear shit, it's not loud. But, you know, luckily they've got someone up there that knows what's going on.
Satellite. You going to Thailand or you going to Philippines?
Yeah, I did. I bought a house in Cambodia.
Cambodia? Wow. You got a lot of Murphy in there?
I hope not.
You just want to be the only one.
It's not a lot. It's more like a lot of French.
You could drive.
Yeah, it's that close. So it's just in borders. Vietnam, Thailand. So I can, you know.
You just.
Yeah.
Hey, meet me over there. I'll pick you up at the border.
Yeah, Philippines is like 3 hours away.
Wow.
Like, yeah. So, yeah, I'm going to figure it out. And I might Airbnb it out, you know, because it's a nice condo. It's got a gym. Cool. Brand new building.
Oh, okay.
Brand new. My son got one more year to graduate high school.
Oh, okay.
After that, then I'm telling him where I'm
going. Oh, you just like pop some
more. Right. Yeah, anytime I'm going to better hurry up and figure out what you're going to do. Bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
My sister got her own business. I said, why don't you go down there and work with her and go to school until you figure out what you're going to do?
Yeah.
You know, since it's her and her husband, they got a big house. And she does everything.
Oh, wow.
So she needs some help. So I'm going to go work with her, go to school with her. You're doing something, I got your back.
Yeah.
Start playing video games all day.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, the support don't stop.
Right.
I hope it work out.
Yeah, it's gonna work out. You got two checks, so you got three checks.
Yeah,
you
got
your you try to get your VA.
Hey, there you go.
Your first, your retirement.
Ladies and gentlemen, our ceremony will begin momentarily. Today's ceremony is considered an outdoor ceremony, and all headgears can be worn by all military personnel. We also ask that you please silence all cell phones and other electronic devices at this time. Thank you.
Front row, left line. Ready? Dress.
Good afternoon, and welcome to historic Joint Base Myer, Henderson Hall. Originally established as Fort Whipple in 1863 and changed to Joint Base Myer, Henderson Hall in 2009. Its main purpose was fortification and the defense of Washington. Since its inception, Joint Base Myer, Henderson Hall has been home to horse cavalry, artillery, and infantry. Today, it is home to the Old Guard, the United States Army Band, and the United States Army Garrison. Before today's review begins, the United States Army Band, Pershing Zone presents a pre-ceremonial concert featuring the following musical selections: Manhattan Beach and The Footlifter. Ladies and gentlemen, your United States Army Band.
Thank you. Once again, good afternoon and welcome. Today, the United States Army Military District of Washington, represented by the soldiers of the 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard, and the United States Army Band, Pershing Zone, pay a special tribute to several soldiers who are retiring after many years of distinguished service to the United States Army and our nation. Participating in today's review, from left to right, is the United States Army Band, Pershing Zone. Formed in 1922 by then Army Chief of Staff, General John J. Pershing, the United States Army Band is the premier band of our senior service. Pershing Zone provides musical support for ceremonies and special events in our nation's capital and throughout the United States. The United States Army Band is under the direction of Major Aaron Morris and led by Drum Major Ben Cadle. Elements of the Old Guard include Honor Guard Company, commanded by Lieutenant Nathaniel Mason and led by Sergeant First Class Alfonso Roman. Next online is Battle Hard Company, commanded by Captain Joshua Orkin and led by First Sergeant Brian Christian. Next online is Charlie Guard Company, commanded by Lieutenant Connor Stevenson and led by Sergeant First Class Stephen Urey. Following is the Commander-in-Chief's Guard, patterned after the unit created by General George Washington in 1776 to be his personal guard. The Commander-in-Chief's Guard is commanded by Captain Orrin Dennett and led by Staff Sergeant Blake Cameron. The last element online, dressed in the Continental Musician's uniform, is the United States Army Old Guard, Fife and Drum Corps. During the American Revolution, musicians wore the reverse colors of their parent infantry unit. The men and women of the United States Army Old Guard, Fife, and Drum Corps maintain this tradition by wearing red coats instead of the infantry blue. The Corps is led today by Drum Major Barrett Newman. Ladies and gentlemen, moving into position is the commander of troops for today's ceremony, Lieutenant Colonel Charles F. Wall, Commander, 1st Battalion, 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard. Since the days of the American Revolution, the colors have been one of the most important elements of a military unit. Therefore, taking the center of our formation in just a moment and bearing the national color is the nation's foremost color team, the 3rd Infantry's Continental Color Guard, led by Sergeant Jesse Hover. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the advancing of the colors. Thank you. please be seated. The history of the 3rd United States Infantry Regiment reflects the growth and development of our nation. 55 well-earned battle streamers, 2 valorous unit awards, 3 meritorious unit commendations, and 5 superior unit awards attest to the Old Guard's record of bravery in action and achievement during peacetime. In 1922, the War Department granted permission for the Old Guard to pass in review with bayonets fixed. The Old Guard will now fix bayonets to the traditional beat of the drum.
Sound, fix bayonets.
Ladies and gentlemen, taking the reviewing stand are the reviewing officials for today's ceremony. Colonel David J. Keppel, Chief Warrant Officer 4 John D. Duran, and Command Sergeant Major Angel L. Ortiz Guman, accompanied by the host, Major General Trevor J. Bradenkamp, Commander, Joint Task Force National Capital Region and United States Army Military District of Washington, and Command Sergeant Major Roberto Guatarama, Command Sergeant Major, 3rd United States Infantry Regiment, the Old Guard.
Order! Order! Order!
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the advancing of the colors and remain standing for the United States National Anthem. Please be seated. Major General Bradenkamp and Command Sergeant Major Guadarrama are now moving into position to honor the retirees. Please feel free to applaud your soldier as they are called. Headquarters, Department of the Army Special Orders. By order of the Secretary of the Army, the following soldiers of the Department of the Army are retired. Colonel David J. Keppel, Military Intelligence. Chief Warrant Officer 4, John D. Duren, Ordnance. Command Sergeant Major Angel L. Ortiz Guman, Adjutant General. Colonel Michael J. Beardy, Armor. Colonel John C. Becking, Engineer. Colonel Brian J. Chivers, Aviation. Colonel Wayne O. Dehaney, Logistics. Colonel Yolanda M. Hines, Finance. Colonel William W. Horn, Infantry. Colonel James D. Monesco, Medical Corps. Colonel David W. Navarrato, Field Artillery. Colonel Joseph R. Parnell, Logistics. Colonel Christopher R. Quayle, Military Intelligence. Colonel Bruce W. Terry, Armor. Colonel Timothy D. Walsh, Medical Services. Lieutenant Colonel Curtis L. Byron, Aviation. Lieutenant Colonel Nicole L. Clark, Acquisitions. Lieutenant Colonel Kenneth French, Military Intelligence. Lieutenant Colonel Vernal J. Fulton, Logistics. Lieutenant Colonel Douglas B. Herman, Medical Services. Lieutenant Colonel John E. Hill, Infantry. Lieutenant Colonel Jared M. Lang, Aviation. Lieutenant Colonel Francisco Ortiz, Signal Corps. Lieutenant Colonel James L. Richards, Engineer. Lieutenant Colonel Howard Mark Sinclair, Military Police. Lieutenant Colonel Antoinette C. Parmenter, Engineer. Lieutenant Colonel Christian G. Curie, Field Artillery. Major Simon A. Boyd, Field Artillery. Major Brendan M. Curran, Signal Corps. Major Kenneth A. Lazat, Aviation. Major Jennifer A. Mahoney, Military Intelligence. Mr. Daryl T. Hudson, Officer of the Chief of Public Affairs. Chief Warrant Officer 4, Sherry S. Stewart, Adjutant General. Chief Warrant Officer 3, Jimmy D. Burns, Military Intelligence. Chief Warrant Officer 3, Owen A. Dennis, Cyber. Chief Warrant Officer 3, Stephen E. Ford, Adjutant General. Chief Warrant Officer 3, Vickiana Franco, Military Intelligence. Chief Warrant Officer 3, Stephen A. Roth, Aviation. Chief Warrant Officer 2, Norman C. Williams, JAG. Sergeant Major Shea M. Blount, Transportation. Sergeant Major Julie A. Guerrera, Military Intelligence. Sergeant Major Tammy J. Harkleroad, Logistics. Master Sergeant Ryan M. Augustine, Military Police. Master Sergeant Jason R. Crawford, Transportation. Master Sergeant Marcus M. Daniels, Quartermaster. Sergeant First Class Brenda Daniels, Quartermaster. Master Sergeant Antoine J. Gaines, Military Intelligence. Master Sergeant Alu I. Hall, Adjutant General. Master Sergeant Daryl T. Hudson, Military Intelligence. Master Sergeant John D. Makowski, Combat Medic. Master Sergeant Shondell O. Paris, Adjutant General. Master Sergeant Denise M. Quintana, Adjutant General. Master Sergeant Jonan C. Root, Medical Services. Master Sergeant Daryl W. Shaw, Military Intelligence. Master Sergeant Sybil A. Walker, Adjutant General. Sergeant First Class Robert L. Acevedo, Adjutant General. Sergeant First Class James L. Crawford, Transportation. Sergeant First Class Terrence F. McClellan, Adjutant General. Sergeant First Class John C. Sykes, Adjutant General. Sergeant First Class Dominique D. Thomas, Signal Corps. Sergeant First Class Rosemary N. Wells, Adjutant General. Staff Sergeant Timothy P. Bridge, Infantry. We are proud to recognize these soldiers' devotion to our country, and we wish them happiness and prosperity in their well-earned retirement. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the posting of the colors.
Post colors. Staff right. Face.
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, Major General Braden Camp.
I'll take a quick drink. What a great ceremony, right? Well, you won't find a better ceremony anywhere, so please let's give a round of applause to the Old Guard and Pershing Zone who did such a spectacular job today. Distinguished guests, senior leaders, command sergeants, majors, friends and families, and above all, the soldiers and families to be honored here today, thanks for making the time to attend this important event, and welcome to historic Joint Base Myer Henderson Hall and Conmy Hall. On behalf of the Secretary of the Army, the Honorable Christine E. Warmoth, Chief of Staff of the Army, General James McConville, Sergeant Major of the Army, Sergeant Major Tony Grinston, welcome. What a great day here in the National Capital Region, and a great way to honor these 62 veterans. I'd also like to thank the soldiers and all those behind the scenes who helped make this ceremony possible today. As you know, these things don't happen by themselves, and so beyond just the old guard and Pershing Zone, all the protocol folks and the teams, and to a degree, all the members of the staff that helped prepare the resumes and get everything situated so we could recognize these folks today. Let's give them a round of applause, too. So these soldiers we recognize today joined the Army to be all they could be. Some joined the Army following Desert Shield and Desert Storm. Others after America was attacked on 9/11. All have stood ready to meet the challenges and the uncertainties of the global war on terror that brought almost two decades of continuous combat operations. They stand here today representing the best of America. As I said, today we honor 62 soldiers and their families for the faithful and dedicated service to our nation. Collectively, these soldiers represent almost 1,000 years of service in uniform. And almost 120 years deployed in combat in support of our nation. With service around the globe and in a variety of combat arms, combat support, and combat service support specialties, these soldiers, leaders, and their families answer our nation's call and could not have served any more proudly during a period of persistent conflict. They also serve to train and lead our young men and women, our most precious resource, to deploy into harm's way and to do our nation's bidding. Our Army and our nation owes you a debt of gratitude for your service and sacrifice that can never fully be repaid. The medal and the U.S. flag are but a small token of appreciation for your service. I would also like to take a moment to thank the families that are here today and those that could not be here for your service and your sacrifice alongside of your service member. As I said, the last 20 plus years have not been easy, 30 for some, and they would not have been able to do what they've done for our nation without your love and support. So please, let's give a round of applause to all the families. I would like to take a moment to talk about our flag, Old Glory. That you receive a flag on the occasion of your retirement is significant in that it is the symbol of our nation and recognized around the world. We have fought to protect the freedoms and our way of life, and we wear the stars and stripes proudly on our uniform, both home and deployed. The red color in the flag symbolizes hardiness and valor, for which each of you has personified as a soldier and leader in our Army, operating in austere conditions with limited resources to accomplish the most difficult and challenging missions. The white color reflects purity and innocence, which you have sought to protect both here at home and abroad. And the blue color represents vigilance, perseverance, and justice, which each of you has demonstrated in the conduct of your duties as officers and non-commissioned officers. I am sure the flag holds special meaning for each one of you, as it should, given your service to our nation. But as you walk out of Conmy Hall here today, take solace knowing you leave behind an enduring legacy that lives on in the countless soldiers you have trained, mentored, and inspired. The Army is better because of your service. Ladies and gentlemen, please give me another round of applause for these 62 incredible soldiers. So once again, to our retirees here today, thanks for your service. You are warriors and soldiers for life. So I ask you to humbly, I ask humbly that you take on one last task. Tell the Army story to help maintain our all-volunteer Army by sharing your experiences with America's sons and daughters so they might be inspired to follow in your footsteps. Volunteer to support and defend the Constitution against all enemies, foreign and domestic. We continue to serve as a shining example around the world because men and women like you volunteered to serve our great nation. So again, on behalf of Secretary Warmoth, General McConville, Sergeant Major Grinston, the Joint Task Force National Capital Region and Military District of Washington, the United States Army, and a proud and grateful nation, thank you, good luck, and Godspeed. Heed the Guardian, winning matters, and be all you can be.
Hold guard. Attention.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and join in singing the Army Song. The United States Army is honored to have presented today's special ceremony. Thank you for attending, and enjoy the rest of your day.